I am in this weird spot where I'm like right between this like shadow of a tree, and so I have to stay in this like perfect frame. But guess where I am? I'm in California! I'm so pumped! It is 70 degrees here, and it was only supposed to be like 60 today. So heck yeah! It's like 70 degrees warmer than Idaho almost. Crazy story, actually. We were in California last weekend because my brother lives here. I'm sure many of you know that. Weston and his wife Greta live in LA. They were supposed to have their baby on the 19th of December, and we like just took a gamble, got these flights because they are pretty cheap, and decided we would come for a couple days, and we left on the 20th. And the baby freaking came a week late. But yay for us, because my mom and I drove like 15 hours to get here to see the new little baby. And you're gonna see him in the video at the end. His name is Win, or his real name's Winston. We call him Win or Winnie. And he was 10 pounds, 6 ounces. So he's a big boy and we love him so much. Win is the cutest and I just want to snuggle him all day. Oh. Can you believe it? 2020 is hours away. Heck yes, baby. The end of a decade. 2019 has been good to me. Some big things have happened this year. I graduated high school, big deal. And then this summer I got to go to Europe, not once, but twice. And it was one of the best summers of my entire life. Europe is amazing. And I loved every second of those trips. I started college at BYU-Idaho. And I made some of my best friends there. London and Sadie, I love you guys. We are gonna have an awesome next semester, but another big highlight of the semester was I got all A's. I put in the work. I was at the tutoring center like freaking 3 times a week at the least. And I got all A's and I'm so proud. One of them was anatomy and physiology. I'm pumped about that. And now we ended the year off with little baby Win. He's the cutest. I have a treat for all of you guys because I did something super cool. And for the past 365 days, I took a 1-second video every day. So now I have this video to share with you all that has 1 second from every day. 2019 was so awesome and I'm so grateful all of you guys are still here watching, like however many of you are left, like maybe 10, 7.
The sun is climbing slowly. I hold these moments closely, closely now. These waves hit a little harder. I know they're gonna carry me somewhere. Step into the open wide. Watch the
our time.
time. Waiting for decisions when the cup of coffee is your true religion. Empty pockets won't do. Just take a walk in my shoes. Come the morning on the but tonight I don't wanna fight. Empty pockets won't do. Just take a walk in my shoes. Come the morning on you. But tonight I don't wanna fight. Find you next to me, I feel it. Sunday morning when I'm sleeping, I figured I'm out, need a change, change, change. Come the morning, I'll need you. Cause empty pockets won't do. Just take a walk in my shoes. Come the morning, I'll need you.
Thanks for watching! I am hoping that this next semester of college, I actually know what I'm kind of doing. Still getting there. But I'm going to make more vlogs. It's a goal for 2020. So, stay tuned. Big things are coming your way. Well, so just for you guys, I have a bonus video. And I'm just going to give you a quick intro on it before you throw up. Every Christmas Eve, we spend with my Aunt Liz and Uncle Todd on my dad's side, the Kilpack side, and we are required to participate in a Christmas Eve talent show because in order for Santa to bring all of your presents, you have to have a talent to share with everyone. My cousin Sophie, she didn't have a talent for the evening and she wanted us to help her. And we came across this video on TikTok of these like 8 boys. They're all sitting like on the stairs or something, all right in a row, and they're like, watch this video, how to make scrambled eggs. They then proceed to crack an egg in the first person's mouth and they pass it from person to person to person. Ew, so gross. But we were determined that Sophie needed to do this for her talent. So we did. So hilarious. And there was probably like 20 of us in the whole living room. And I would say about 12 almost threw up. The only way I was gonna do it is if I was the first person that got the egg cracked in your mouth. And let me tell you, you do not know how hard it is to keep a raw egg in your mouth until you've done it. That's all I'm saying.